Big thanks for joining me on Politics Today that comes live simultaneously on independent television and radio. We apologize for bringing it a little behind schedule as a result of what presently we're facing as traffic gridlock. And some of our guests actually are held in the traffic around Megon area, the S&T axis, and after Mingit at Isiho, Ugbo Lagos Road, as a result of a broken down vehicle, a truck in particular, that is really causing the gridlock along the Megon axis. Well, good to know that we've been opportune to have some of our guests here in the studio to do justice to the topic. As you know, we are looking at issues that are really emanating from the polity, Nigerian polity in particular, and looking at what transpired yesterday over the Twitter suspension by the federal government. You recall what occurred on Wednesday when the microblogging and social network provider Twitter deleted the tweets of the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as he made comments on the issues about some Nigerians who he sees as misbehaving, and saying that he is going to deal with them in the language they understand. He took also a close look at the 1960 to 70 experience of the civil war in Nigeria, and said that those of them who spent 30 months in the field in the course of the war would deal with them in the language they understand. Well, we understand that there are rules of engagement, there are rules when it comes to sending tweets, putting tweets on the account. And of course, we had that challenge with Donald Trump. Donald Trump also had that bit of a challenge. And also, we are having that here in Nigeria as a result of the president's reaction, which basically led to other issues where they said, according to the Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, that Twitter has been biased and playing double standards. And taking a look again at what transpired October 20, 2020, during the hashtag NSAS protest, and said that Twitter seemed to be biased and also allowed a lot of issues to really transpire in the course of the hashtag NSAS protest that led to destruction of property of both private and public sectors. Well, we're all in the middle of this. What is happening? Even the Nobel laureate Wole Soyinka reacting, Sharp reacting, other stakeholders reacting over the suspension of Twitter in Nigeria. Well, discussing this with me, starting from my far left, I have a public affairs commentator, Harrison Izeko. Thanks for joining me, Harrison.
Thank you for having me, good morning viewers.
And of course, I have the convener of the Concerned Edo Citizens Forum, aka the voice of the commoners, Royal Oriwabo. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
All right, in the course of the show, we could be having the great privilege to also have our other guest, Pius Alile, a politician. Well, let's quickly hit the ground running. My name is Philip Omogyupo. And looking at this, I also let you know that in the course of the show, we will be opening the lines for you to participate. Call us on independent radio and, of course, view us on independent television. But be sure to be precise, go to the point straight, and also ensure that you do not engage in anything that could bring about the breach of civil presentation in the language you understand, all right, as pertaining to the media. All right, quickly, let's get the question rolling. First to you, Harrison Izeko. You've heard what has been transpiring and the suspension of Twitter. How do you agree that?
Well, it's quite unfortunate. You see, our president, Muhammadu Buhari, is governing a country where rules does not work. And so, therefore, you feel that whatever you do, nobody can checkmate you. Twitter, there are guidelines. It's not just a body that you think that you drop anything and it must go. It's not new. Donald Trump was a victim. I don't think that he went further to say that he's going to do this or that. What is important is that you must allow people to criticize what you are doing. You must allow people to speak truth to power. What are they saying? We have been crying here. Banned open grazing. You say no way. But it's very quick for you to quickly say that you're banning Twitter because they delete your message in their platform. I think that we must come back home. We must allow people to suggest way forward on what we are doing, to also criticize if you are not doing it well. Yes, our people from the Southeast, the Apple, it's a proscribed group, we understand. But we have been in this country. We are some selected few in the name of cattle rearing have been problem to Nigeria. Mr. President have not taken action. Mr. President have not come up with a very direct statement so that these people can be dealt with. But when it comes to other group, we want to do it in a way that people can see that we are very serious with what we are doing. So are we not one Nigerian? So for me, its action is condemnable. Nigeria should not accept it, because if not, one day they will stop us from talking here.
But again,
we are not a military regime. So if the international community feel that a platform says that what you have done, we don't like it, we delete it, one would have expected that they should come up in a way that maybe even if you want to react in a way that the whole world will not see you as being biased. The following after 2 days, then you went ahead and said you are deleting them, you are banning them from operating.
Well, let me say maybe you didn't get the actual incident that transpired, Harrison Ezekiel, but I want you to react after Royal River Ball has responded to this. We have issues where the president, you know, really expressed his views, expressed his mind, just like other Nigerians will also express their minds. And the Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, did make reference to the hashtag NSAS protest. We all got to know what transpired because we all witnessed it. Now, don't you think that is a way of not allowing the president, Mr. President, to express his views, Roy?
Yeah, thank you. I will protect your job, definitely. I know how the media have been highly be tele-guided in this country under the present administration.
Just be objective.
You know, I'm just being objective, not be subjective. I'm telling you with facts and figure. You know, I am not just a Nigerian. My father and mother, if I have any other identity, I know, and best know to the world, is that I'm an Okwadoama. By implication, I'm in Nigeria. I don't have anywhere I will run to when Nigeria collapses. Is it not a shame? Is it not a shame to all of us that the president we have in Nigeria, he posted an information, a message on a social platform, and he was deleted. That the Minister of Information will not be addressing a world press conference on a main word that was deleted from a Twitter. Is it not a shame? Is it not a shame? Is this supposed to be an issue we'll be talking about? Are you not aware that today, this week can make it a week now, that over 200 people were kidnapped in Niger State? Has Mohammed, let Mohammed be able to someone correct to say, let me talk to Nigeria over that? It's not butter.
Okay, but let's also look at the issues of the hashtag NSAS protest. What occurred? There were also breaches.
About even the breaches.
Why didn't Twitter also take into cognizance
because
those breaches from Nigeria?
I am not happy. It's not because one, the president of Nigeria and those who manage Nigeria further reduce us. If I write something on the social platform, you deleted it to hell with
so
you.
What's my business about that?
Does that some group of persons were asking me this morning when I went for my physical exercise, okay, as a bad Twitter now, does that mean say food go cheap for market? Does that mean that there will not be bandits? Does that mean that Boko Haram will stop Boko Haram? Does that mean children that have been kidnapped will regain freedom? The answer is no. What are you telling me about you ban those things? Because we have a government that does not know what they are doing with due respect to them.
You can't say that.
I said with due respect to them.
With due respect to you too, please. Can I cut
yes,
in?
Yes,
can I cut in? Please. I think I asked you a question.
The question you are asking me.
I asked you a question, please.
I think
we should be civil. We should ensure we educate the viewers and listeners of independent
we
radio.
Have got it to
and Rory Wabo, I know that you are aware that in the course of this program, a lot of people are enlightened, educated.
Definitely.
And I asked you a question which you seem not to want to answer the question.
Question.
The question I asked you is, don't you think this could look like a bias? Because in the course of the hashtag against us protests in October 2020, there were also breaches from other Nigerians. Why didn't Twitter take account of those breaches?
Listen to me.
Why so
Twitter,
particular
Twitter
about the president?
Twitter is not just a social platform. They are also there to make money for themselves. They are also there to make money. If they say, I don't need your money, do you know anytime you post on Twitter, they collect money from you?
Yes.
Are you aware? That if they say, we don't need your money, then heaven will not collapse. My brother, in terms of those breaches you are talking, go do your research. He just said that my very good friend, the last president of America, the former president, Donald Trump, He posted on Twitter. He tweeted and he was deleted.
Okay, are you saying that
the president, this is not the first time the president of Brazil, let me tell you, he tweeted and he was deleted. The president of Venezuela tweeted, he was deleted. My brother, let us place emphasis where they are supposed to be emphasis. We just announced, we started this program, where 15 minutes behind schedule. Do you know why? Because I could not access Unibe and Barack. I was there for over an hour. Between Unibe and do you know why? Because we have a federal road safety who does not have a toy van. Nigeria is not bothered about that. I expect the Nigerian government to be saying, what do we do? How can people between Unibe? That's why emergency between Unibe and Barack. I spent over an hour and the Nigerian government is not bothered. Lab Mohammed will not come out to say, how do we rescue the situation? Go and look at the pain and the suffering going on. Some of us, we abandon our vehicle, we have to trek. We will not even see who we take. It's as bad as that. My brother, let us focus on what will make this country to be great. Let us discuss what tomorrow we are living the world. How, what kind of society are we living for our children? That's my focal point about this.
Okay.
This is whether Twitter is biased or not, that's not even the subject matter. It is the whole platform. As far as I'm concerned, Twitter is not different from Red Solid Associates Limited, a platform where I used to make money.
Okay.
That's not the platform.
I'll come back to you.
If I don't want to do business with you, I don't want to do business with you.
I'll come back to you, Roy. Harrison Izeko, if we get Roy properly, he seems to suggest that the reason why Twitter could be biased, seemingly not even taking account of breaches by other major population, but rather taking account of a breach by the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, it could be for the purpose of economic. Do you agree?
Well, let me comment this way. Do you know why they target the president? If I tweet now, I make statement. My statement will not have effect. The way they manner the center, the statement made by the president, it referred them to what happened during the Civil War. Saying they are going to deal with those people that you are indirectly saying that during that this is what happened. And such a statement cannot be encouraged. If I make such statement as Harrison Izeko, it cannot be effected. Because why? I do not have the power to do it. The statement is coming from a man that had the power to do such thing. The statement is coming from a man, the president of Nigeria, from a dissident. If such thing is not there to guide him, you will see it tomorrow. Like my brother said, is that the issue we have now? That your tweet was deleted, ever we fall, Nigerians will die? Lai Mohammed should be cautioned. He called a press conference, the way a man was talking is provoking Nigerians. Tomorrow, they will ban Facebook. Tomorrow, they will come and tell you we should not come to ITV again and make any statement. We are not in a military regime, this is democracy.
Okay,
people should be allowed to speak truth to power, to criticize government if they are not doing well. If they are doing well, then they are doing well. What we are saying, the president and Lai Mohammed should use his strength to go and ban open grazing. The governments are met together as we speak now. They are facing serious resistance from the federal government not to allow what they have agreed to see the light of the day. We have not made any comment on that. Today you cannot travel anywhere. These people that are doing, Nigerians with evidence have said that a particular ethnic group are the people responsible for.
Okay, I'll come back to you, Harrison Izeko. Thank you for your contribution. I'll come back to you, Harrison Izeko, and big thanks, Raoul Babu.
An addendum to what
you said. No. You will get the addendum after this break, please.
We'll
take a short break. Thanks, in case you're just joining us, as Politics Today on independent television and radio going on simultaneously. We'll take a short break. Do stay.
Independent television is live 24 hours on GoTV channel 107, Star Times channel 130, and TSTV channel 346. And you can watch from any part of the world on Roku TV, Smart TV, Amazon Fire TV, and Android TV. For your favorite programs, news, current affairs, and lots more, you don't want to miss our objective and balanced reportage, entertainment, and sports. Follow us on all our social media platforms on Twitter at ITV Radio NG, Instagram at ITV NG. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/ITV Radio NG. Like our Facebook page, facebook.com/ITV Radio NG. Visit our website for more news stories and lots more. www.itvradionigeria.com. Watch ITV via live streaming on the internet. www.itvradionigeria.com. itvradionigeria.com/live. Also remember to visit your mobile app store and download the ITV app so you can watch on the go. For advert placement and commercials, please call the following numbers: 0805-563-8573, 0803-775-5024, 0708-365-2474, and Independent Television, certainly.
Thanks for joining us again. We appreciate you for taking our time to be part of the show again. And we are on the issue concerning Buhari and the suspension of Twitter. And also, after this time out, we'll be looking at Obaseki and good governance with special focus on the embattled lawmakers-elect of the Edo State House of Assembly. Before we take that, we had the opportunity in the course of the break to enjoy the presence of an erudite and articulate politician, and he is Pius Alile. Thanks for coming, Honorable Pius Alile.
Thank you very much, my brother. Good morning. It's nice to be here again.
Thank you. We'd like you to share your thoughts over this, because there has been issues about Buhari and the Twitter suspension over the comments. What do you share in this?
Yes, I think we must realize that democracy does not start with elections, and winning elections and losing elections. No. Democracy must be taken holistically in every areas of our national life. And that includes politics, that includes our actions, that includes on human rights, and that includes on freedom of speech. All these things put together in its entirety, that is what makes up democracy. So it's not just winning an election and winning an election. Even in the actions of democratic elected government, their actions must portray actions that deepen democracy in every aspect of our national life. So whatever stifles our freedom of speech is not acceptable, and that is a fact, irrespective of the issues. I keep saying that the issue of IPOP, you cannot subdue it. You cannot, it's not possible for you to say, oh, they should stop agitating. You begin to use weapons. It's not gonna work. We must learn dialogue, because dialogue is one of the most important aspects, most important ingredients of democracy, and we must learn how to talk to each other and learn how to compromise, give and take. That is how you run government, and that is how you run system under a democratic elected government. A government under democracy must be emotionally intelligent, irrespective of the provocation.
Okay.
Your actions must portray democracy. Otherwise, it becomes autocracy. Otherwise, it becomes dictatorial. I understand very clearly the issues around the banning of Twitter. Yes, the government made it very clear that the Twitter they appears to be supporting the
bias,
and we all know that when it comes to journalism and mass communication, the issue of bias is a very sensitive issue. You have to be able to balance.
Okay.
We understand that.
Okay.
But it's not proportional to the actions that the government are taking at all. The actions that the government are taking, stifling the rights, freedom of speech of millions and millions of Nigerians, on account of that, is not proportional. And that is why government must look at their actions in terms of what they do and how they react to issues. And you will recall recently that Facebook also banned and deactivated the account of Donald Trump, the United States of America. He didn't, even when, with all his kind of character of Donald Trump, he did not.
So it's not peculiar to Nigerian president.
No. If you look at it, that one was also deactivated completely, deregistered. But he did not say I banned Facebook on account of that. You understand?
Okay. What do we do going forward? Because there could be possible implications of this.
Oh yes.
Maybe economically and otherwise.
Absolutely.
So what's your advice to the government in this regard?
This is why the government needs to be careful in terms of reacting to issues. You see, a government must be emotionally intelligent to handle issues in a democratic manner, in a civil manner, rather than coming up with a banner here and there. So I think that the government must look into their actions again. You understand? As far as I'm concerned, it is not acceptable at all. They must look at it again and reactivate what's it called, the Twitter,
okay,
and let us begin to enjoy the services.
Okay,
you know, millions of people, millions of Nigerians are using Twitter. They are using that particular social media platform,
okay,
to air their view, and even businesses. And if you look at it, it's already the diplomatic community have started to react as well. In terms of the international arena, people are beginning to react very negatively to this, and the government needs to look at it. We need to begin to look at, we are part of a global community. We need to be very careful the way we behave, because otherwise they begin to see that we are not democracy.
Okay, thank you very much, Pius Salile, for your fine presentation on this. Let's quickly do as a follow-up of this, where the federal government did say that the NBC should be taken implementing some strategies on licensing the OTT. Yeah, and this basically would culminate into them having a meeting on Monday, June 7. So what are your thoughts in terms of the NBC coming into this, and how it's going to go about the licensing of OTT operating in Nigeria?
You see that this government will always want to expose their inefficiency. But telling us that these people have been operating here, you don't even know what they have been on for several years. And that is why we are saying that, in fact, their statement is a compounding issue for them. Let me tell you, after that meeting, they won't talk about it again. It's Nigeria. After this particular time, that is the end of that story. Another one will come aboard. The government must be sincere. They should not react to every issue. Allow Nigeria to criticize this government. Allow Nigerians to suggest. Allow the international community to suggest to you the way to go. There's so much insecurity within your country. People want to help you. You don't want to hear. The world has gone global. Nigeria want to go back to the old good days that day.
Okay, thank you.
Nobody know what is
thank
happening.
Thank you, thank you.
So my brother, I don't think anything good thing will come out from that.
Oh, well, let's see how it goes. But what's your reaction over that? Because possibly NBC will be holding a meeting to strategize in this direction.
Holding a meeting is not my issue. My issue right now is, how do we get Nigeria back? There are many distractions in this country.
Where has Nigeria gone to?
There are many distractions in this country. I will continue today. The issue we have, the greatest distraction today, is constitutional review. I said it on my Facebook 2 days ago. I said we are being distracted with this constitutional review because it's heading nowhere. As I was gathering people, the momentum was high. They came with the issue to Twitter. That Twitter have deleted the post. Now all our energy are now channeled towards Twitter.
So you see this as a distraction?
Yes, then we have abandoned a fundamental distraction again to another monumental distraction. And that is where we are. That a president of a nation, the minister, is bothered. He's bothered. I watched news yesterday, and so women, parents from Niger State, they were weeping. One woman said, I have 3 children there. For the past 1 week, no information, official information from government. Just take your mind back that you will have children. Three children, you have not seen them for 1 week. The Nigerian government is not bothered. The Nigerian government is not bothered. Is that the society you want to live in? The Nigerian government is not bothered that people have been kidnapped. You are talking about your Twitter.
Thank you.
Is it the first time we are doing this?
I believe this country belongs to all of us.
This administration is not going to be the last administration we have in this country.
Thank you. Let's get your final words on this issue. You see,
whatever regulations you are putting in place, it must not stifle our freedom, our right to freedom of speech.
Okay.
I think whatever regulations, probably to curb insecurity issues, whatever thing you are doing, the freedom of our citizens is a right that must be entrenched. It's a right that must be upheld.
Without inciting violence, anyway.
Without inciting violence, absolutely.
Without tempering the corporate existence of the country.
People are free.
Are you not worried about that?
People are free to air their views.
Okay.
We are not in a military regime. People are free to air their views, irrespective of that views. Allow them to speak.
Okay.
Allow them to vent their anger. It is part of democracy. You understand what I mean? Without that, there is nothing you can do about it. And at the end of the day, we are still coming back to the table to talk.
Thank you very much, Pius Salile. Thank you. I think this is a learning process for both the leaders and the followers. And basically, as the federal government made a ban on Twitter's operation in Nigeria, we just hope that it will look inwards and also find a way to take the otherwise decision because economically and otherwise, it doesn't augur well for Nigerians. Well, we leave that to look into the issues bordering in the state. The victory of the governor in the Supreme Court, Governor Obaseki Noregase, where he made huge progress, and that seemed to put paid to litigations. And as a result of that, the APC candidate of the Edo gubernatorial election 2020, Osagyeze Iyamu, made a congratulatory message to the governor of Edo State, Governor Obaseki, where he did say also appealed that the governor should look into the case of the embattled lawmakers elect, 14 of them in number, and how that issue can be settled out of court in order to have quality representation of the constituencies that are not, as we speak, are represented adequately in the House of Assembly. Again, that also sparked a lot of reactions, and the governor also reacted to that, saying that the fate of the lawmakers embattled in court will be decided by the court. Well, let's get your reactions on that, Harrison.
Well, first of all, thank God Almighty for the victory of the governor. It shows that God loves us so much in the states. That battle was, I don't think we'll face that kind of battle again politically. Yes, the candidate of the opposition would have congratulated the governor. One would have expected him to just send a congratulatory message instead of making requests at that level, that not make the team to look as if
there are conditions tied to it.
He was not sending a message. You don't give orders when you have exercised your rights as a person
to the highest
the level of Supreme Court. If you didn't go to court, you are sending this kind of message. We begin to listen. The man went to court. He went from there, went to appeal court. From appeal court to Supreme Court. By the time you are going to a level that nowhere to go, you are now coming to congratulating your opponent. You are not giving him order that he should or they can settle out of court.
So by that you are saying it's coming.
For me, my I'm very straight on the issue. Mm. I was a legislator at the local government level. My brothers, I sympathize with them because very many of them never need to end this way. Let them follow the window in the court. It should allow them to get to a level of Supreme Court. Whatever be the outcome at the end of the day, they should come back home. If you don't want to appeal, then after that they can appeal.
Okay.
For him to go to Supreme Court and not telling his
It's a constitutional right. Mm. And once you have exhausted that, irrespective of the outcome, it is a civilized behavior to congratulate the person that defeated you. I don't think there is anything wrong with that. It is not all about election. Oh, I won election, I lost election, let me congratulate. After you have exhausted all the court processes and you are true, you can congratulate.
Now let me come. But he made an issue concerning the condition that seemed to be tied to the congratulatory message.
There was no order. You need to go and look at it again. It was not an order. It was a request.
So it was an appeal?
Absolutely.
Okay.
You appeal and order, they are two different things. You understand? He said you are now in a vantage position to consider these four legislators, the issues around the 14 legislators. But I want to say this very, very clearly. I want to make this very clear. That it is the responsibility of the governor of the state to ensure that democracy is deepened. I say it every day. It is his responsibility to ensure that the judiciary is intact. It is his responsibility to ensure that the legislatures are intact.
Is that not why he said that their fate should be decided by the court? Is that not a way of also giving flesh to democracy?
No, let me tell you. I when I came here just I talked about dialogue. We there are so many issues you resolve through political discussions, and you are able to get solutions to it. We've resolved so many issues in this state just through political conversations and through dialogue. You reach an agreement. Everything is not about the court.
But again, we look at issues that have been surrounding this whole predicament. They've always asked for a window to bring about reconciliation, which didn't come up.
I'm not true.
So you can't be saying it just now.
I'm not true yet. It is his responsibility. I know he's enjoying the fact that he's using very few members of the House to run the state. It is an aberration, constitutional aberration, an affront
on the concern of this country. I'm telling you the fact. And let me also tell you, a lot of constituencies have not been represented over the last 4 years. It is wrong, and it is an affront, and as far as I'm concerned, it does not tell well of his government.
But again, reports have it that the members were invited to be inaugurated, which they refused.
No.
How in any way can that be the problem of the government?
If you want us to go into the circumstances that led to this situation, we will not leave this place. We tell her, if we want me to go back to give you a summary of what actually transpired, that is a different matter. That is what they say is in the courts now. But the point I am making is that you can still discuss and find an amicable solution to this kind of situation.
Thank you.
If you say, oh, because you have won in the courts, and our congratulation is coming too late. That's arrogance.
Thank you. Like you said, this is a very sensitive issue. That's if we allow more articulation, we would exhaust the whole time we have in the whole day.
Absolutely.
You just said that. Well,
absolutely.
Let's also give room for those who will be pulling the call through to us for listeners on Independent Radio. The number is 0522 90573. I believe 0522 90573. And of course, also viewers on Independent Television, ensure that your presentation is civil. At this point, you can get your calls pouring at us. But let's get to have your viewpoint, Royal Rubber. You heard what he reacted over that. So what do you think? Are you on the same page with him?
I'm already very emotional now with what has happened in this country. You know, at the time,
I saw myself sharing tears for this country. You know, he spoke well. The only thing he just said I don't like is that, for you, I will be sitting down with you here. The number one man of Edo say, you say it's an arrogance on him.
No.
The adjective you used just now. You know, I take exception to that. You are my friend. You are my friend, but I take exception to that for you to look into my face. The governor of Edo say, you will use the adjective arrogant? But I won't take that from you. I'm telling you that with all level of all responsibility.
Can I correct you?
You know, you have to quickly.
Can you speak up that, quickly?
The fact that you said just now that our congratulatory message is coming too late, I am saying it's arrogance.
Okay, you are talking to him. Okay, if you are talking, that's okay. Let me.
Not by any way making that reference to God.
No, let me.
So that comment is not.
No, so let me make. I have the floor.
I think that's exactly what I'm making now.
We congratulated the governor. And we congratulated the party that he belongs. If they are throwing it to our face, we are saying it's arrogant. It's as simple as that.
Yeah.
And I'm not. I'm not apologizing.
Okay, quickly. Let's get your view.
Now,
Roy.
Now we know the process that happened. I'm happy when he was talking. Is my friend. If we are living here, he told me that we'll be drinking wine together today. Therefore, that will tell you the relationship we share. You know, for now. We are aware. One of the fundamental, what makes it to be democracy?
Okay, quickly, I think we have to take a pause on that. Let's take this call. Hello, good morning, caller. Please tell us your name and where you're calling from.
15 minutes.
Okay, what's your ventilator opinion in this respect, please? Open secret. Thank you, Open Secret. Thank you. Thank you, Open Secret. Thank you, Open Secret. Well, Open Secret just reacted over the topics and basically spoke on the Obaseki and the congratulatory message. He said issues like that should be left alone, that is coming belated.
Of course. That is the reason why when he was talking about smoking. You know, we are running a democracy. It's a process. He said that they went to Supreme Court to pursue an agenda. I salute them for that. Now, the issue is that I am aware, the issue of the 14th legislature is already pending before a court of competent jurisdiction. Mm. We cannot reduce ourselves as a state. We now reduce ourselves as if we are not, it's not one organization that does not have rules and law. We are running a democracy. Once you finish, the bitter truth about it is that I'm even very constrained to even want to speak, especially when I know that those who are directly involved, my twin brother is there, Chris Okabe. Therefore, you know, when I see an arrangement like that, the kind of,
Let's quickly take another call. Please, I think we should pause. Let's take another call. Good morning, caller. Tell us your name, where you're calling from. Chief Ned.
Chief Ned. N-E-D Ned.
Okay. Thank you. Let's hear what you have to say.
I want to talk in respect of the 14 lawmakers. These 14 lawmakers who went and inaugurated themselves in a private house gave orders to the government. To the Commissioner of Police, got letters from the Attorney General of the Federation thanking them. These are the same people coming to ask for pardon or swearing in. They have already lost all their rights. So they should take it as such.
Thank you, Chief Ned. Thank you, Chief Ned. He just had his opinion. You still have the floor, Roy.
Yes, if you aggregate all the opinions so far, you aggregate it, you congregate it, you know, you marry them together, you will know that of a truth, since we are running democracy.
Okay.
I'm aware that this matter...
Let's take this other call. Hello, good morning, caller.
You know where those calls are coming
from. Okay, tell us your name, where you're calling from.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. What's your name, please, and where are you calling from?
Okay, my name is John Bosco, calling from Benin.
John Bosco from Benin, go ahead with your opinion.
Yes. Okay, I'm to make my little contribution. You know, in regard to the banning of Twitter, you know, what I see in that is that the executive arm of the government want to silence Nigerians, not to air their opinion. And the most funny part of this cool thing is that they are banning Twitter, they are also spreading the information on Twitter. Go to our president handling Twitter, you will see the banning of Twitter there. Just like you are telling his father you don't want to do business with him, and you are using his way to communicate with other people. That is that. In regard to the 14 lawmakers, they have gone to the court. I think they should wait and know what their fate will become in the court of law, because they said that that is the only way. And in regard to what the governor said, that the congratulatory message was coming too late, the governor was right. Just like you fighting me, at the end of it all, you told the people the whole world that you are going to beat me in this battle. At the end of it, after we fought, and I defeated you, and I came to me and said, I'm sorry, I know you will defeat me, but I just want to try. Let us assume they defeated the governor. What would they have said? Would they have sent the congratulating message to the governor?
Okay.
Wait for the court.
Thank you very much.
The people who voted them, we are angry with them.
Thank you very much.
They separated themselves from the government. So let it be so.
Thank you very much. He just ventilated his opinion that they should wait for the court judgment. Just as the court judgment concerning the gubernatorial election, even the certificate forgery was graded upon.
Let me quickly conclude.
There's nothing wrong in that. Okay,
so
right.
That people can have a bond, you know.
Yeah.
We have a saying in my dialect that Aregbe, you know, Gwa, Aye, your Shigbe. You know, that was the first thing when I heard there was a contradictory message. The first thing I did, I said it was unnecessary. This is not the era. There are things you allow it to happen naturally. All of us are from Edo State. In another 4 years, in another 3 years again, you want to run again. which is very consistent in running, and we still have an opportunity. I don't say we remain at those states. You know, therefore, coming against and all those, they were things some of us never even, to some of us, we were also very disappointed. We were disappointed because it was uncalled for. Because one, even some of us, even we wrote on our personal capacity, even when we addressed a press conference, calling on the after the election, that all of us are from Edo State. Before you know it, it will be another 4 years. There was no even why we should even go to court in the first place. Some of us, that was our position. And we also appeal. Then after you have ventilated to the highest level, you are coming back to say you exercise your right. And I salute you for that. But now revising. I see you are on the river to say congratulate me. You know, to me it's civilized to you. Maybe because I'm a village man. To me.
Okay, thank you. It's thank a you very much. I think we'll take that as your final words on this segment. Let's get your final words on this segment, Harrison.
Well, for me, like I said before, I never said that it's arrogance. What I said is very clear.
He's just sitting to you. He knew what he said.
He never said his rights to the Supreme Court. Yeah. He should allow my senior brothers to exercise their rights to the level of Supreme Court. Maybe after them, anything can happen. It's not only them. In my own council, where I serve, we were 12 that went there. It's only 5 of us that entered the team. Because 7. We are also a victim of what we are talking about. It's a matter of choice. Till tomorrow we are good friends. It's a matter of choice. People decide this is what I want to do. And remember, in every decision you take,
there are consequences.
And you should be prepared to take it. So for me, that is where I stand.
Thank
Let
you.
Them do it. There's always a tomorrow. Nobody should fight each other. Because you will do your tenure, you will go to those states, remain like, as my son brother have said, opportunity will come tomorrow. I think that's where we stand.
Thank you. Okay, Parasite, before I allow you to speak, please be very sure of what you say and be civil.
It's not the last to conclude.
Anything you say is your opinion and not your opinion of independent television and radio.
There are consequences over government actions as well.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of constituencies are underrepresented at the moment. That put credibility issues to the actions of government from the very, very beginning to date. And that is will also be subject to litigation at appropriate time. So it is important, it is imperative that we resolve this issue as quickly as possible. We cannot have constituencies not represented at the Edo State House. We can't have that. It cannot continue.
But in as much as you also said that democracy should take its full course. I remember you said that just now.
Excuse me, hold on.
Don't you think it's also ideal for the court to decide the case?
I have said it just now. That is the responsibility of the government to ensure that every arm of government is carried along in government.
Of course. And so it's a bit of the judiciary to do that.
So that there will not be credibility issues around the actions of government.
Yes.
So the issue of congratulatory message, it is a civilized behavior. I don't care whether you are doing it now or you are doing it
to you.
It's
not a civilized
behavior. And even if I took you to court, you defeated me, I congratulated you, it is appropriate. It is not, there's no hard feelings about it. It is either you accept that congratulation or you reject it. Then that congratulation has been made. And it's in history that it has been made. And that is my position on that.
Thank you very much, Pius Alele, for taking our time to be part of this. And big thanks to you, Royal River Ball, a.k.a. Voice of the Commoners.
We have 5 minutes.
Thank you.
We have minutes. Why are you in the hurry to shut us up?
Yes, we are pressed. On Independent Radio and, of course, our viewers on Independent Television. We do this again same time next week.